Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff comfort me. The word, zombie, refers to the reanimation, or resurrection, of a dead human corpse. Zombies are often referenced in fictional horror stories. However, the reality of zombies, and the symbolism associated with zombies, has a long history throughout antiquity. The word, zombie, came into the English language from Haitian folklore. In Haitian voodoo, the high priest, or sorcerer, is able to reanimate the dead using what is perceived as magical necromancy. In reality, the sorcerer gives a living person a potion containing a poison extracted from a puffer fish, which causes the drinker to appear paralyzed as though they were dead. The sorcerer then buries the person in a shallow grave. When the paralyzing potion wears off, the person is able to crawl out of the shallow grave, and to onlookers, it appears that the dead have arisen. The sorcerer then intercepts the newly risen zombie, and gives the person mind-altering drugs called Datura, which makes the person act detached in a dreamlike state, and able to be mind-controlled by the sorcerer. At this point, the person has been reanimated from the grave, and doing the bidding of the sorcerer, and can be termed a zombie. In Haitian voodoo, zombie is another name for the lower energy Damballa, who rules over life, animation, mind, and intellect. Damballa is known as Obatala in Nigeria. In the Yoruba tradition of Nigeria, Obatala is the creator, shaper, and animator of human bodies from clay, much like the Islamic god, Allah, who animates lifeless clay, and the ancient Egyptian deity, Khnum, who also animates lifeless clay. In the Bible, Jesus creates a zombie when he resurrects Lazarus from the dead. In fact, Jesus himself can be seen as a zombie god, or dying and rising god, much like Osiris from ancient Egypt. The process of creating zombies, mummies, or reanimating the dead, can be found throughout Africa. The word zombie, from Haitian voodoo, comes from the Central African Congo word, zombie, which means fetish, and nzambi, which refers to the life, vitality, and the energetic source of all creation and movement. The African Congo word nzambi is akin to other words found in a multitude of traditional African systems including Njambi, Nyambi, Nyami, Nyama, Emba, Ama, Ama, Amit, and the ancient Egyptian deity, Amun. The ancient Egyptians also had a ceremony which was used to animate statues and deceased bodies, called the opening of the mouth ceremony. In the year 2012, there was an epidemic called the zombie apocalypse, due to a number of people using drugs laced with bath salts, which caused the person to act with mindless zombie-like behaviors. In fiction, a zombie apocalypse occurs when a widespread rise of zombies, hostile to human life, engages in an assault on civilization. The rise of zombies, and the spread of zombification in fiction, is usually spread by some illness, sickness, mental disease, or plague. In recent years, the number of TV shows and movies about zombies has also increased, including Night of the Living Dead, The Mummy, I Am Legend, I Frankenstein, I Zombie, and The Walking Dead. As previously mentioned, the word zombie is related to the word Amun, which means hidden. The word apocalypse means to uncover, disclose, or reveal. So, a zombie apocalypse actually means to reveal what is hidden. So let's reveal the hidden symbolism of zombies. The three major monotheistic religions of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam all promote the concept of zombies, with the belief that one day, there will be a day of resurrection, where all the dead people will rise from their graves to be judged by God. First of all, any intelligent person can reason out that there is no such thing that one day, the bodies of all physically dead people are going to rise from their graves and take on form and life again. That is against the laws of nature. Furthermore, even if a physical resurrection could happen, there would not be enough room on planet Earth to hold all human bodies that existed, going back to the beginning of the evolution of humanity, 10 million years ago. Therefore, since zombies and resurrection cannot occur in reality, then this means it must be symbolic. Much like vampires, zombies are undead, and are symbolic of people living during this current time of the moon cycle of death. The sun cycle and moon cycle of time also represent different levels of mental activity. Like day and night, you are more mentally active during the day when you are awake, and you are less mentally active at night when you sleep. Likewise, during the sun cycle, people are mentally alive, and during the moon cycle, people are mentally dead. Zombies represent the mentally dead. This is why zombies are depicted as mindless. This is also why zombies want to eat your brains, because they need brains, because they lack brains, or are mentally dead. Like zombies in fiction, The zombie virus of mental death can spread, and is infectious and contagious. The mentally dead are all people who are sheeple, not conscious, not woke, and ignorant about the basic laws and knowledge of absolute nature. There are three kinds of death: mental death, spiritual death, and physical death. You can be resurrected from all the forms of death except for physical death. Resurrection from the zombie state of mental death occurs when people mentally awake and rise from the graves of ignorance, deception, and unconsciousness. If you are indeed rising from the grave of mental death toward mental life, you will indeed survive the zombie apocalypse.